Let's begin. I would like to introduce you to Kaizen's own Executive Vice President, Mr. Tom Forsythe.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us here at Tech to Tech. Today, we're going to talk about how validation test protocols sometimes don't look like life experience 30 days out, which is really the goal, and discuss why that gap exists when we're talking about cleaning. So, move on to my next slide here. Oops, oh no, there we go. Okay. Again, cleaning process validation testing is where this begins. And that's usually a runoff, right? Sometimes there's one or two products. Usually they're run under identical or the same process conditions. Sometimes those have been studied well and are optimized. Sometimes they're just recommended in an estimate. Usually these tests run for maybe a few hours, and usually they're followed by test cards being sent out for some confirming lab testing, and those are good practices. And at that point, often a winner is chosen, and that winner is the one that performs the best during those few hours. But when you think about it, maybe only a few cards were run, so maybe the cards were only really in the machine for minutes, not hours. And of course, it's very hard to understand the costs during a very brief test like that, so that it's hard to have a good sense of those costs. Of course, if something bad shows up, is objectionable, the product does something really that you don't like, you can see that, and that, of course, has an impact. And like I said, those outside lab tests become important, but that data comes back, you know, later, usually weeks later. So if, you know, you hear me, I'm saying, gee, this testing evaluation maybe is minutes or a couple hours, small numbers of samples. But we all expect our wash baths to last for weeks, if not months. And of course, you have a broad product line. They've got to be effective for all those, everything that you make that needs to be cleaned. And can you really achieve that confidence to know you're making a good choice when you're only testing a handful of parts? Well, we would suggest that maybe that's not the best way. Maybe it's a good start, but it's not the best way. So how else can we perhaps do this? Well, like I said, the testing method, the validation testing, is a really good start. Maybe not quite as fast as Mr. Bolt here in the middle, but very fast. And it's good to remember that, you know, the cleaning products must clean, right? And cleaning is the removal of an unwanted contaminant, a soil, from a part, something that you like. We can't harm the substrate or the part. We need to rinse it, be able to rinse it completely from that part, so there's no issue for a coating or some next step in the manufacturing process. That's all very important. And of course, cleaning agents must touch that dirt, that soil, because if there's no unwanted contaminant, there's no reason to clean. And of course, many people run no clean and do not clean, and that's acceptable. But if you've decided that that contaminant is not okay, then not only do we need to remove it, but we need to manage it carefully, because of course this wash tank is going to last a long time. And so soil management must be a key part of product design for the cleaning products. So, you know, manage a contaminant by a cleaning product. Well, how does that happen? Well, it sort of starts with a quick understanding of how cleaning products go together. The old-fashioned saponifier, usually these are very old products, mostly not sold anymore. They had very high pH, 11, maybe 12. They reacted with the fluxes, which were acidic, so you had the low pH and the high pH, good reaction. You know, that part worked well. The tank life is usually quite poor. Measured in hours. The old-fashioned solvents, well, they dissolve things. They don't react. They are generally neutral. They needed to match the soil, but that usually worked pretty well. And a solvent would absorb until it's saturated, just like every other solvent. So then they'd stop. And then there's the surfactant approach. Surfactants undercut. Surfactant means surface active agent. So it has a likes the surface better than the soils. It kind of pops them off, and that works quite well, but it's challenged with the baked on soils. You know, our because the soils are complex, those cleaning products, nowadays the cleaning products tend to be a mix of all those technologies. Because those soils are still acidic, all fluxes are acidic to do what they do, that acid is coming into the wash bath. It's got to be managed, because if it's not managed, the wash bath will become acid very quickly, and that's not a good choice. Solvency is very important for cleaning products today. Solvents mostly do not have pH. They usually can manage a lot of soil, but they become less effective as that soil builds up, as you get more soil in there over time, and that causes rinsing problems. So today's cleaners, as I said, are really a combination of these things to get the job done. And that rinsing part's really, really important, because you're only as clean as your final rinse. That rinse water must be high quality, and you also need the amount, the right rinse water quantity in a batch. That's the number of rinsing cycles, maybe two, maybe five. Sometimes there's a resistivity measurement to help with that. And on an inline or bigger system, what's the flow rate? How many liters per hour, per minute, or per hour are going through? Make sure you have lots of rinsing. And not all material, not all cleaning products rinse as well as others. Sometimes that happens in the very beginning. Quite normal for it to happen after several weeks when that soil grows in the tank, because that makes it more hard to rinse. And often that rinsing is what causes a bath change out, because it's really the rinsing problem that shows where the issues are. So the key is balance. Products today need enough solvency to clean, but not so little that they shorten bath life, because you need to have lots of solvent to be able to absorb that soil. And you need to manage enough pH to manage that soil. Not so little that it won't keep the soils in solution. Not so little that if I put an acid into the bath becomes acid. We don't want that to happen. So we need strength and balance to do a good job. Because after all, manufacturing processes run for a very long time, run for weeks. You know, we don't want to change these things. And life happens during those extended times. Contamination builds up. The cleaning products themselves have to work and do their job. And your products change. You have many different products that you make over that time, over a few weeks. And the cleaning process needs to be effective for you. That's quite important. So the classic validation run really shows you life in a perfect world. But most of us don't live in a perfect world. So how do we evaluate the real life? Well, again, the validation approach is a good start, great start. You run those tests, but usually the results are quite similar. Even in doing the lab testing, usually, again, the results not clear because there's more than one good product on the market. So we believe that step three should not be a decision, but rather an extended field trial. Extended because it should be measured in weeks. Field because it should be on your production floor. And that validation data gives you the approval to use that product in production. And a trial, of course, allows you to learn, because that's really what we want to do, learn and evaluate. Does the product work as well on day 7 or day 17? How about day 27? Will it last that long? How is rinsing holding up? Is there any foaming? Water-soluble soils, OA fluxes, are known to be big foamers. The cleaning product, if you use a cleaner with the water-soluble, has to manage that foaming. How's your consumption? Is it stable? Were there any unexpected positives or negatives? That's what you're after, because the beauty of doing an extended trial is you get your data. You can review the data. You don't have to see it in a very short time window. You can see if there were surprises, compare the results on day one to the last day, really understand your economics, because you now have a few week window to really understand it. And did anything change? Did it change because you got really good results and you were able to improve? Did it change because maybe the results were not good and you had to adjust for that? So again, the key is in manufacturing and in washing and cleaning, it's a long journey, and there are ups and downs and some bends in the road, and some days it rains. Cleaning materials, like all processes, we want to be a balance of strength. with that whole idea of balance coming together so people can do our jobs. We want to have data. We want to be data driven. That's a big deal. Because if we do all that, then our life really is that perfect world, and that's what we're all hoping for. So that concludes my talk today. I'm going to give it back to Cassie, and if you have any questions, please enter them into the chat box, and Cassie will let me know about them.
All right. Thank you for taking this short break from your busy day to take part in our Tech to Tech. You will be receiving a follow-up email with a short survey and an opportunity to ask any questions you were not able to ask in this session. If you'd like to discuss this topic further, please contact your local Kaizen regional manager, or you can send an email to tech@kaizen.com, and we will have someone schedule a follow-up with you as soon as possible. Again, we thank you for taking the time to join us today, and we hope to see you again soon. Stay safe, stay healthy, and have a wonderful day.
Thank you for coming. Have a nice day.